May, everyone. We are, of course, here in New York, where today, which is our final day here, isn't it?
Yeah.
We don't have much time at all. I know, it's going to be over so quick. Today, we're going to be exploring New York. Our first stop is going to be the Nintendo store right behind us, where we're going to try and pick up some goodies and see what they've got in stock and see what's changed since last time. So as we're going to ram so much into today, we're going to try and bring you guys with us on everything we do. On top of going to the Nintendo store is to go to Central Park, see how crazy it is. Apparently it's always lit up with lures and really good Pokemon. And also update you guys very quickly on everything that's happened so far in terms of Pokemon Go. We had some big egg hatches, a few cool wild captures. But to kick off this episode, there is the best Pokestop possible we can spin, which is also, believe it or not, my 7-day streak. So...
oh, you timed that well.
Yeah, everything is linked up very well. Now, if we boot our Pokemon Go, we should be spawning right on top of the Nintendo store. And the Nintendo store actually has its own Pokestop. We're going to take a picture.
It's Donkey Kong, isn't it?
It's a Donkey Kong. So, let's take a look. So, guys, let's start off this episode with a 7-day streak on Donkey Kong from the Nintendo store. Nice. Come on, give me some good stuff. Oh my god.
Only one Ultra Ball.
I know, I wish I could have got more Ultra Balls and Great Balls. But to start off our day with an awesome 7-day Pokestop streak is amazing. So let's head into the store, see what they've got, and start our Pokemon adventure here in New York. Guys, welcome to the New York Nintendo store. This is the bottom floor. There's two floors in total, and the bottom floor is great. If you love Mario, it's great. If you love Pokemon, we're going to go upstairs in a second. They have down here playable consoles. They've got huge plushies of Mario and the whole of the Mario squad. They've also got a load of amiibos. You know what I'm like, I'm an addict when it comes to amiibos. So all the collection is here. It is so cool, and as a Nintendo fanboy, we adore this store. It is amazing. So downstairs is awesome, but I know you guys want to see all the Pokemon stuff, so let's head up one more floor and see what's upstairs where we can find all the Pokemon stuff. So guys, we've come upstairs and this behind us is the Pokemon section, but unfortunately there's not as much stuff as it was last time. Do you remember how much we bought last time?
It was like the 20-year Pokemon anniversary.
Yeah, it was.
This whole section and like all the way up to there was all Pokemon plushies everywhere.
We even brought home that huge Pikachu plushie you can see in the background on our sofa. We've got that here, we've got trading cards, so much stuff. And there is still some bits here, and you've actually got a little present, haven't you?
Yeah, I'm not going to
have myself some socks. Nice. And I'm going to find myself something to buy from the store this time as well. Now, unfortunately, there aren't any of the Pokemon plushies we wanted, but I think I've spied something in the Zelda section, so I'm going to pick something up from this top floor from the Nintendo store. So guys, behind me is every Pokemon game that has ever existed within like the main Pokemon line. So all the way from Red, Blue and Yellow on the Game Boy, all the way to Sun and Moon that I'm playing at the moment. So I'm going to show you guys all of these Pokemon games. I want you guys to leave a comment section down below letting me know which was the first one you played. For me, it was actually Pokemon Gold on the Game Boy Advance. So leave a comment down below and I'd love to know which was your very first Pokemon game. So guys, we've made it to the southernmost side of Central Park. If you look behind, like we could be in the middle of the woods right now, couldn't
we? Yeah, it looks crazy.
It's so green and we love all the parks in New York. If I spin around, There is huge buildings, skyscrapers everywhere. It's one of our favourite things about New York, is like the fact that both merge together so nicely.
And if you're in the middle of that park, you would never know you're in a city.
No idea. Apart from the fact there's lots of loud, and the New Yorkers here love to use their horns, cars everywhere.
Oh my gosh, they love horns.
Like, literally, it's hard to sleep at night, they use their horns so much. But the first thing we've got to do here is to open up some 5 kilometer eggs. These are so close to hatching near the Nintendo store, and as we've arrived, they are ready to go. So obviously, Togepi is the one that we want.
How many chances have you got?
0.5% chance for each one, but I think
but
I've got 4
eggs?
Chances.
Five.
Yeah,
okay,
yeah.
Okay.
Psyduck, not the one, unfortunately. I'm not even gonna bother appraising him. Come on. Now, I have got a 10 kilometer on the go, which is very exciting indeed. Oh my gosh!
What? Is that your first ever one?
Okay, so guys, I'll let you in a little bit of a secret. I have actually had a Pichu before. It hatched, I think, a few weeks ago, and Claire and I filmed it hatching at home, but it glitched out a little bit. The egg animation, remember the egg animation didn't play? We're like, oh, what's happened? And I went back, and it was just there.
Oh, I was gonna say, I don't remember doing the opening thing.
Exactly, so it was. I never put it in a video, but this is the first one I've ever hatched on camera, so that is amazing. Pichu and Togepi are obviously like the best ones you can get for 5Ks. If we get Togepi now, mug shot, not quite what we want, unfortunately.
No,
I wonder if the IVs any good. I would actually be interested. We've got good IV. Oh, it's not even one, but okay. I think it's our final one right now, guys, and then we'll check in Central Park and see what it looks like. Come on. Togepi! No! Not quite, unfortunately, but. Oh, what? Okay, hold the phone. We've got one
this
more chance,
New
guys.
They can't move very fast.
That's a really good point. Well, the one more chance was exciting, wasn't quite, unfortunately, there. Ooh, Lapras found a candy. If we look around Central Park, it's not quite as lured up as I thought it would be, but there's a load of stops,
a load of Pokemon.
That gym's just been taken. Let's get ourselves another Pokestop and see what we can get. I need to refill all of those eggs now. Oh, 2 kilometers.
Nice. Okay.
Nice. So we're going to keep on walking around, refresh all of those eggs, and see what Central Park can offer. So, guys, we are wandering into Central Park, and as much as we love this place, how freaking cold is it?
It is. So cold.
You've got little Pusheen gloves on.
I know, but they're doing nothing. Nothing protects you against this kind of cold.
It is very, very cold. We've never been to New York this time of the year, so we knew it would be freezing, but we were hoping it wouldn't be this cold when we decided to go out and about and film. But I just wanted to talk to you guys a little bit about why we're here and what's going on, because I haven't even explained why we're in New York or where we're going next either. So we've been in New York now, it's our final day for about 3 days, haven't we? It's been super quick.
This is like the first chance we've got to properly record as well.
Exactly, so this is the first day we've gone out and about, and it's cold. But the reason we came here is because of DRL, which actually the guys can see on my hat here. I did some filming with them, learning how to fly drones in Ohio, and we've both come out for, basically they did like a qualifying series here in New York, where the winner, they all qualified through online like racing and being as quick as possible. The winner got a $75,000 contract to become a full-time drone racer, which is insane. So that's why we're in New York. But although today is actually our final day in New York, we're actually going on to a place called Lake Tahoe in North California, aren't we? Where
it's gonna be even colder.
It's gonna be even colder because what we're doing out there.
We're gonna go do some skiing. We have been learning to snowboard.
Yeah.
But snowboarding is one of those things you actually need a lot of time to learn how to do. And even though you've never skied, after a couple of hours of practice and learning, you'll get the hang of it.
Yeah.
Snowboarding, you just can't do it that quickly.
It's so much harder. So this is gonna be my first ever ski holiday. So you'll see a vlog at some point in the near future of me trying to ski for the very first time. So that's what we're up to next. But while we're in New York, we're embracing this cold and we're trying to find out Pokemon nearby. If you have a look on my screen, actually, I've got an Eevee, 2 Pidgeys, 2 Executes, and a Nidoran. Basically, there's Executes everywhere. And I've also got potentially a new best Pokemon to fill into my squad. Now, we weren't the only YouTubers to come out for the DRL like qualifiers. There were other YouTubers as well, weren't there? There's KSI, Lachlan, who's also a big Pokemon fan. There's a lot of Pokemon Go stuff as well. And also twins, Tiny Turtle and Little Lizard. Now, I have been sitting on 2 10Ks, one of them being really close to hatching for ages, and I wanted to hatch it with Lachlan. Now, why do you want to hatch it with Lachlan?
Because Lachlan's Pokedex is impressive.
Yeah.
He has everything, everything except a lap.
Yeah, and lap fastest can obviously come from 10Ks. Now, there was no guarantee that this 10K would give me a lap fast, but I thought, you know what? If I could hatch it with him and get a lap fast, it'd be amazing. Unfortunately, I wanted that. I want that screenshot, you know, of me pulling out a lap fast and seeing how he reacted, because he still hasn't had one. Now, unfortunately, he had to fly home a little bit early, so I didn't get to do it with him, but I did hatch a 10 kilometer. I'll show you on screen here while we're in our hotel room. It hatched too early, unfortunately, and you wouldn't believe it, but a Lapras did pop out. I'm so annoyed I didn't get to film it with Lachlan.
So
would have been the greatest thing on YouTube. It would have been absolutely amazing. But although that 10 kilometer has hatched, I've still got another one on the go, because I said I've got two. So we're trying to walk that one off as well. If any of you guys are massively into Friends, this is the fountain, like the intro scene on the show, isn't there? And actually, this is the very first, one of the very first places we went to, which first went to New York years ago. And I'm gonna pull up a picture here, which I think is on our Instagram, of Claire and I sitting on the edge just there. Do you remember that picture we took? And it's always cool to come back to places you've been to before. Yeah, you've got the same shoes there as well. This is also a good spot to sit down and chat to you guys a little bit about me potentially getting the best, the strongest, the greatest Pokemon in my squad, which is very exciting. So guys, let me update you on something that could potentially be very, very cool and I'm very excited about. So if we go to my Pokemon and go to the best CP, obviously at the top is Gyarados 90 at 2,945. Now, one thing I'm always looking to do is to get an even better, stronger squad, and to have potentially a new Pokemon to hit that number one spot is very exciting. So I realized that Rhydon here actually has a higher CP potential than Gyarados. And the only reason this Rhydon is so far behind is because if I go and appraise him, he's not like to make much headway in battle. He's pretty rubbish IV-wise. So I was thinking, if I can get a Rhyhorn that's a better IV than Gyarados, he could take my number one spot and actually overtake him, which would be very exciting indeed. So I went to all my Rhyhorns. I've got one that's 1,100, it's huge. But I found this guy here that's a 91% IV Rhyhorn. Now, I'm not gonna power him up quite yet, but as you can see, I've got 122 candies. So at the end of this episode, or towards the end of the episode, once I've spent the whole day capturing Pokemon, if I haven't beaten this guy IV-wise, I'm gonna power him up, and I think he's gonna become my new best Pokemon. Now, my buddy Pokemon has been Lapras since last episode, and I've been walking him, let's see now, almost 30 kilometers, but since hatching that Lapras that unfortunately Lachlan didn't get to see, I now have 40 candies, so I can do a little bit of powering up on that guy. Let's find where is he sitting at, where he's sitting at on my 100% IV Lapras. So let's do a little bit of powering up and see how strong he's gonna get. All right, I think this could be my last powering up. I actually can't reach his maximum CP because I still, despite hatching a Lapras, do not have enough candies for this guy. But with this final power up, he's now 2,576. Let's see where he sits on the list. Wow, he now comes in at our number five spot, which is so exciting. Wait, I was 9 out of 9. Have I just hatched some egg? There's two eggs, guys. All right, what are we saying? 2 5-kilometer eggs. I have no idea what they're gonna be. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Now, if I got a Rhyhorn from here, this would actually be amazing, because as I said, if I can get one that's above 91 IV, that would be the best thing possible. Come on, 5K, hit me with a Rhyhorn, hit me with a Rhyhorn. It'd be so, so good. Just after I said it, Vulpix. Hey, that's still a really awesome one. Love that, absolutely love that. I think that's just those two. But it's great because I was just gonna check in on my actual eggs. I've got 3 2Ks that are literally like a few meters off of hatching. I've got a few more 5Ks, and then the big bad boy 10K, which hopefully could walk around enough today in New York, we'll get 2 10-kilometers hatching in one video right here. But let's pick up this camera, let's embrace the cold, let's find Claire that's wandering around somewhere trying to stay warm and see what more Pokemon we can find. Guys, we have not yet turned into ice cubes, almost.
Well, pretty close.
Almost. Now, just caught up with Claire. You did a big loop while I was doing that powering up.
I did so many
warm. Are you feeling a little bit warmer?
No.
We've got some 2Ks though, so I actually have all the 2K Pokemon, and since the starting event is now over, even then,
it's all about Caterpies and Weedles.
Yeah, that's what I want, baby. Give me them Weedles and Caterpies. I actually don't have many Weedles or Caterpies, believe it or not, because I just disregard them so much.
Right, Weedle's so OP.
No. No, oh my god. Is this a joke? Are you trying to troll me right now?
His ratio of appearing is OP.
If I get 3 out of 3 Weedles, I'm actually going to have to, like, I think I'm going to have to, like, sacrifice to the Pokemon gods for giving me such bad luck. What?
No, you can pick it. Gyarados.
Okay, let's see.
How many candies
do you need? 805. Oh
you
my god.
You get two Gyaradoses?
Yeah, I can get two more Gyaradoses. How crazy is that? Let's see.
You should appraise it.
My fingers are so...
It's like, I don't recognise a human touch.
Honestly, a second ago my fingers were so cold, it didn't. A Magikarp's alright. I mean, it's probably one of the worst 2K openings you could have, but hey, at least I've got enough candies now for two Gyaradoses.
That's pretty amazing. Yeah, I've got
too much candy. Unlucky!
Guys, Central Park is so big, but it doesn't just have one Pokemon spawner. It's literally built up of like multiple.
Two Squirtles just spawned me, which is awesome, but a second ago, there were Bulbasaurs. So literally, this park is so big.
Oh my gosh.
I was just saying, we got a Bulbasaur a second ago, and now Squirtles. This park is so big, there's multiple spawners within the park. So it's Execute, Bulbasaurs, and Squirtles. All from walking around Central Park, which is so cool. So I hope I can get both of these guys. So guys, you can see we're now on the edge of Central Park. We're actually gonna leave and get some food and see what Pokemon we can get while we wander the streets. If we take a look at all the Pokemon I got in Central Park, I've just got a Diglett actually and a Pokemon Go Plus, Execute, Growlithe, Squirtles, Bulbasaurs, and then some of the Pokemon we actually hatched from the eggs. So a really good mixture of Pokemon, but after the event where we found Blastoises, Charizards, Venusaurs, it's hard to get those kind of crazy spawns we've had in the past. We also see, like, oh my gosh, there's so many. I am surrounded by so many birds at the moment.
They're so cute.
What we do just as we leave Central Park. Now, you guys always tweet me and always ask me, where's Eevee? What's going on with Eevee? What's going on with the cats whenever we leave to go on holiday? And normally my parents live so close to us, they'll look after Eevee, but my parents are still out in Australia, who actually got recognized. My mum got recognized in the zoo playing Pokemon Go, which I think is crazy that my family get recognized halfway around the world. So shout out to you guys about it to my mum. But Eevee's going to be looked after by my aunt. The cats are someone to check in two times a day into our house to make sure they're okay. So Eevee's having an amazing time. My auntie has loads of dogs, so she's fine. So I thought, in remembrance of Eevee, I will take this 696 Eevee, and I'm just going to evolve it straight up and see what we can get. Now, if the Eevee power is strong, hopefully, I can get myself a Vaporeon. I do not have a single good IV nor CP Vaporeon at all. So I haven't played the game since day one. So it's gonna be your turn, isn't it? Yo, it's really your turn.
Oh, every time.
That was my second best EV at 696 as well. It's a 2,100 Jolteon. If that had actually evolved into a Vaporeon, it would have been absolutely huge. Unfortunately, no such luck. But Eevee is fine. We miss her dearly. Fortunately, apparently, the Eevee power isn't strong enough to get us a good Vaporeon. But let's find ourselves some place to eat and see if we can get ourselves a better Rhyhorn along the way. Has gotten somehow even worse.
Yeah, it's raining now.
It's absolutely pouring. We've had such a nice meal and we are definitely
so
warmed up, aren't we?
Yeah.
We needed that so badly. We've actually got 3 5-kilometer eggs right now and the 10K is about 2 kilometers from hatching. So walking back to the hotel room to actually get our stuff, ready to make the flight to Lake Tahoe, which is going to be very exciting indeed. So
you'll definitely get your 10K tomorrow.
You think so? Okay. Claire's positive. 2 10Ks in one video, baby. Now, I'm looking for, obviously, Togepi, but I really wanted to hatch 100% IV Rhyhorn. Okay?
Yeah.
That's not easy, but I want it to happen. 100%, yeah.
Okay, I'm positive, but that's really...
It's gonna happen. All right, let's open this up. Look where we are.
Rhyhorn is in 5K.
Okay. Rhyhorn is in 5K, so it could happen in one of these. Freaking Nidoran female.
Not what you want, Bubba. It's not a Rhyhorn.
I'm not even gonna check its IVs. It's got 100% one anyway.
You've got so much rain on your phone that
yeah.
I'm actually worried
it
about
is
the
so
phone.
Wet right now. Oh.
Still your boy.
It's still my boy, Ghastly. Let's see. Is he 100% IV? No, he's not even a wonder. All right, third and final one. What are we saying, guys?
It was like
yeah. It was more than on the cheek.
Yeah,
I've already got 100% IV one of these, so let's have a look. Wanda, HP, oh. Unfortunately, not the 100% IV ride on we wanted, and not the toga bead that we both still do not have. How? We've both hatched hundreds of eggs each. Hundreds.
Disgusting.
But we're going to walk off this final 2.5 kilometer for this 10K and get ready for the huge, the big, the best ever Rhyhorn evolution and potentially get my strongest Pokemon ever. Ever. Pokemon Go.
Ever.
So guys, we've given up, we've ordered an Uber to get back home. We've only got 2 kilometers left on the 10K, but I had a single 2K, and Claire convinced me not to record it.
You were like, I'm not gonna record it.
No.
And I was like, I never got my 2K either, because we don't need anything. And somehow it's on my phone.
So I didn't record the 2 kilometer, and look, it's a freaking Igglybuff. It's an Igglybuff. So we've got ourselves another baby Pokemon for this episode. And we're still waiting on that 10K, I think. That the taxi on the way back, the traffic here is so slow and it's so rainy.
Oh yeah, we'll get hatches.
Should be getting our brand new 10K hatch. So, fingers crossed it can be a smoochum. The only 10 kilometer egg I need left. So let's jump in the taxi and walk off or drive off those final distance. Made it to the airport and we're getting ready for you. You literally just started eating. I'm sorry, I caught Claire off guard. We got some really nice like Asian noodley food ready for our flight. Really, really tasty, honestly. And this is great news because big things are happening right now as soon as we get in the airport. So first of all,
our flight is in 20 minutes.
Fun that. Okay, we've got a 10K to hatch and potentially look here on our nearby list is a Grimer, which is literally, wait, which way is it? I think it's just behind me over there. So I'm actually gonna try and grab that and try and find it because we go to our 10K, it's at 9.95. All right, guys, so let's head in that direction. I'm gonna leave Claire here for a second. Sorry, babe.
Our food is gonna be gone.
Off to get a Grimer. Let's do this. It's at 9.99. I think this is gonna hatch before I can get to the freaking Grimer. I'm gonna have to run back to Claire again. Guys. We got it. Let's head back to Claire. Let's capture this thing, hopefully, and then see what our 10 kilometers is going to be. Update time. I walked in the wrong direction.
No.
It wasn't that way. It was that way.
Yeah,
just as I was about to get there, my head got to 9.99, and then the Grimer spawned it. So I got the Grimer on the screen first. Okay, so.
Pretty good as well.
Yeah, it's not too bad. Not too bad. Grimers, as you know, are a rarity. Okay. Food on the go to power me for this capture. I like it.
You know what? I want to know from you guys. Do you have a muck? Like, serious question. We are like, what, 7, 8, 9 months since release of this game? I still don't freaking have one. I know I could be walking it, but I've been walking my Lapras. All right, Grimer's caught.
Oh, nice.
It should be 10 kilometer. Okay, okay.
Smoochum?
This is gonna be the final 10K egg of this video. I need a smoochum, okay?
Mm-hmm.
What do you reckon it's gonna be? I've had one Lapras, which has been pretty ridiculous.
Yeah.
And actually, I was looking at my power up, and if I get a Snorlax, I'll be just as happy because that has a really, really big CP potential, okay?
Okay.
So,
I'm always happy.
Yeah, exactly. Snorlax, Aerodactyl, obviously.
Oh, yeah.
Dratini will still be great, I don't care. And then Smoochum will be a brand new one. So, let's do this. Oh my gosh. I don't want to be another Electkid or Magby. Yo.
Oh my
gosh! No! I do not believe it! Wow! Guys, I could not have ended the New York part of our trip any better. Normally we're holding the camera when I freak out.
Yeah.
That is so good! I honestly have had unreal baby luck, haven't I? I've now got all of them. Do you want to do a little animation? I've now got every single baby Pokemon apart from a Togepi. I can't believe that.
I cannot believe that.
Wonder, Defense, wow. Honestly, my egg luck is ridiculous. So guys, all we've got to do now is get ready for this flight.
All right guys, let me just fill you in on what's just happened. Pokemon Go, hatching a Smoochum, as lit as it was, it made us miss our flight. And
I mean, let's not blame Smoochum. She's the innocent party in all of this.
Yeah, it's our, it's both of our fault. So I've never missed a flight in my life. I've had close experiences and have almost missed a flight, but Alright, so we booked a direct flight, which is very hard to do, from here in New York to Tahoe.
It's the only one.
It was a 6.5 hour flight straight there, and it was the easiest thing. And we didn't realize they closed the gates 15 minutes before and never opened them. We were 2 minutes late.
Yeah, and they don't even have someone waiting at the door.
No.
It's not like BA. They just don't care.
We weren't the only one. An old couple rolled up in a wheelchair. Bam, ain't letting you in. Like, oh, you're playing Pokemon Go, fam. You're late, get out of here. So we're freaking out. We're going to the help desk. There's no one at the help desk. There's like this rating thing at the help desk. It's like, how do you rate the experience here at the help desk? And I was smashing, I'm so angry. And then this old other woman comes along. She can't get any help. She's smashing it, and we're like, how do we get home? Like, how do we get to the car? Don't want to go home. Claire's like, I think we're gonna have to go home. Like, we're just gonna have to get our bags redirected. This trip's over. And I was checking a website that I always use for our flight. Literally. And it was saying there's nothing till Thursday. The guy in Odessa says there's nothing till Thursday. Luckily, what were you doing? What were you searching on?
I used Google. Thank you, Google.
I was like, okay, that's pretty straightforward.
But it said there was flights, but they were all like 16, 17. 24 hours.
It's ridiculous.
Ones.
It's ridiculous.
Not continuous.
Like, finding this flight was so hard because it was direct. And this option now is 6 hours to LA, which is California.
It's like 6:51.
There you go. And then we've got an 8 hour layover in the middle of the night. So we're probably going to sleep in the airport or at a hotel. And then a 2 hour flight to Tahoe. And we will arrive at like 10 a.m. in the morning.
I'm like literally tired just thinking about that.
Oh my gosh, I cannot believe it. I cannot believe it. The good thing is A, we're getting there.
Yeah.
B, we're still together. We're still a couple.
Lots of couple, yeah. I mean, an hour ago, it was such a go.
And although this is going to look so bad on us, it's going to look so bad on me, because the last thing I did was put down our phone to go to the flight. But we're making it.
It was Grimer.
It was A, Grimer. B, getting hyped for Smoochum. But you know what? I wouldn't change it for the world. All right, well, guys, the good thing is, don't play Pokemon. No, the good thing is making the flight. Lesson learned, don't play Pokemon Go when you've got 15 minutes for a flight. I've still got to pay out my Rhyhorn and find them.
I feel like I'm shaking.
I mean, we were sprinting, but look. Like, I sweat so much.
I don't sweat, so it's fine.
Alright guys, let's just cool down for a second. No one's boarding the flight quite yet. They should give me a few seconds to power up this Rhyhorn, relax. And then we can make our way to Lake Tahoe. Guys, today's been ridiculous. We're about to board on the flight just behind us there, but I promised you guys I would do this powering up and this evolution to get my best Pokemon potentially ever. So I'm gonna do it. We are about to go to Lake Tahoe. The next time you see us, we will be skiing, hopefully. It should be very exciting indeed. As I said, I've never done it before. I'm definitely quite nervous, but let's find him, okay? Here we go. Rhyhorn 91. Let's evolve this guy. And the biggest thing will be how many candies will I have left and how high can I get to him? Because I don't have enough candies, potentially may not be able to power him up as high as I need to maybe get him. Maybe my first 3,000, definitely my best Pokemon ever in Pokemon Go. Here he is. What CP is he going to come out at? That is the question. Look at me, I'm so hot. I was sprinting so much. 1,000. Ooh, Rock Smash and Earthquake. A really good moveset, not the best, but a really good one. Let's start the powering up, and fingers crossed, my friends, I have enough candies. Let me know, guys, what is your highest CP and your best Pokemon in Pokemon Go, your number one Pokemon? Let me know down below. Has he made it to number one? I don't have any more candies. He's so close. All right, guys, we gotta go. All right, he is technically the best Pokemon I have. We're about to board our flight to Lake Tahoe. We get more candies in Tahoe, don't worry, we're making number one, baby. But thank you so much for watching this video. We got a Pichu, a Smoochum, an Igglybuff, almost the best Pokemon that I've ever had so far. We'll see you guys in Tahoe, where Claire and I will be skiing. Thank you for watching. We're gonna try and relax, get on this flight, not miss it. We'll see you guys soon. This is where we're going to be going. It looks steep when you're actually up here. It looks really steep.